the heck out. All right. So it's a beautiful day and I wanted to get outside and I just needed to get out of my house. I have class today and it's so hard to focus while I'm at home. So I'm going downtown, going down to my school, I'm gonna rent a room and take some time to focus on my studies. Yeah, I'm freaking anxious as heck. Well, I don't have COVID, so that's cool.
Deciding to pull the plug and get the tarot deck. It's the only one that's called out to me at this point, and it's what my soul wants, my witch soul. So I can't ignore myself, you know? I like to follow that 3-day rule. If you still want it 3 days later, then you truly want it. It's been 4 months at this point, so I think I really want it. So I'm gonna go ahead and get it, and then to justify it, I'm gonna do a YouTube review video. You're gonna get to see it because it's super cool. It's a super, super cool deck. It's by Oliver Hibbert. So, oh my gosh, I can't believe I just bought that. I'm so fucking hype. If you're so afraid of losing money that you just like hold on to it, the universe is gonna sense that fear and it's never gonna bring that money back to you. So trusting that you're gonna be okay and that the universe will bring that money back to you is sending that energy into the world. So I think overall, if it's something you want, it's not gonna, you know, put you out on the street or keep you from eating, you're gonna be okay, then, you know, spend the money. I'm thoroughly confused by this door. I have secured the correct MIDI controller, finally. So I'm ready to make some music now. Already a sensation, so the world's not ready. So.
Also, look at this city. She's so pretty when the sun's going down. Ooh, sunrise, sunset, baby.
Thank you.
okay, this is a finished project. I recorded most of it, but I didn't record all of it because it was starting to be like going on 3 hours and it was getting insane, so I stopped recording it. But that's it, that's my still life. Hold on, let me pull up the picture. That's for my painting class. I didn't do it exact, cut some stuff out, but side by side. Kind of. I don't know where to go from here.
Start going like, throw it back!
Throwing it back! Throw my back out! A bit of a sniffle now. I think I'm getting allergies, which I've literally never gotten allergies before. And I think all of a sudden I'm starting to. I guess it's because I'm getting older or whatever. I don't know. So I went to campus this week, right? Went to campus and it made me really anxious. Going outside sometimes makes me anxious, especially when my mental health isn't doing that great like it is right now. I had to push myself. And what I thought about as I was doing that was this thing that I've learned because of yoga. And like, this is why I love doing yoga so much and why I keep pushing myself to continue my yoga practice. And it was the idea that yoga teaches you to differentiate between pain and discomfort, because it's all about the mind-body connection. As you go into these poses physically, thinking about how that's affecting you, like using your mind to understand, and then from there, after you've differentiated between pain and discomfort, if it's painful, stop. You know, there's this idea of santosha, being content within your body and what it's capable of, so like not pushing it to extremes that it just can't handle. So santosha, contentment, and if it's uncomfortable, hold for another breath. And that's what I thought of when I was super, super anxious trying to go downtown to get my work done. Was it causing me physical pain? No. But was it uncomfortable? Oh, it was so super uncomfortable. So I had to push myself. I had to keep breathing and hold the pose, basically. And it helped me to get downtown. And I think overall it's helping me to live with my anxiety and to overcome it. And just because something is uncomfortable doesn't mean that it's necessarily bad or that it needs to be ended right there. Discomfort is a good thing. Discomfort leads to change. Change is uncomfortable, but it's beautiful and so, so necessary. But yeah, but you know, in case you were wondering what it's like to go to art school online, because that sounds like a really strange thing to happen considering it's, you know, art school and can't really use a lot of the equipment that we were using beforehand, or you know, even if you were just like curious about going to Columbia, now you know. And this is kind of what it's like to go to college during a pandemic. I will say I like the fact that I don't have to leave my house as much, because I used to get a lot of anxiety surrounding like the time it would take me to get from one place to another. It's not that big a deal, but my anxiety thinks it is. And so now the fact that I can like be doing everything I want all up into like 2 minutes before my class, that's super nice. I like that. But overall, you know, I am about to graduate. I've gone to Columbia for 4 years, well, 3.5 years, and I am grateful for the experience. I've loved going to Columbia. I've really enjoyed the people I've met. It's great for networking, although right now it sucks because you can't network, and that's like the biggest thing about Columbia is that it's supposed to be good for networking and finding jobs after you graduate. So that's something that's tricky that I'm sure that they are working on figuring out during this unprecedented time. But that was my week, and so I hope it was cool or entertaining and you liked seeing a little bit of Chicago and what it's like to be an art student in the city, kinda. Thank you for sharing this moment with me. I am so grateful for you. I will see you next week. Bye.